Dear Guruji, I have a question. I am going through this self-inquiry process continuously with your help and guidance. And I am also observing ego, thoughts, emotions whenever it arises. In 24 hours time, I am with your grace and guidance, able to monitor my inner processes maximum time of the day, but not able to sustain the observer role in an ongoing manner. I think in an ongoing manner. I realize mostly I miss this when I interact with others, especially in my office when I perform my roles. The other person, when they bring a subject to discuss with me, their conversation pulls me to my non-bhavam without my conscious and without me being conscious of it, and I also make my judgments, biased views, etc. After the conversation, I realize that I have lost in this process. I have lost myself as an observer to look at my non-bhavam in this process. How do we face such challenges in real life, especially when we play our roles? Please guide. Stephen Francis, Chennai. We have been showing various slides and we have been always reminding that everything, the whole cosmos, including an individual with his office and different roles in the family, outside of the family, and especially in the office, meeting so many people, transacting with many people, discussing with many people, this is what is one's life is. This is already a completely short movie. The movie has been shot already. And that is unfolding. It is going to unfold till the last breath is there. Even the last breath is already a short movie. Our death is also already a short movie. That is, dying to this body, we call it as death. In reality, there is no death at all. There is nothing called as a waking state also. There is nothing called as a dream state also. All these two objective states. In dream state, can you do this inner gaze? Can you do this self-inquiry? Because it is fixed, preconceived dream. The dream is over. The dream character, the dream hero. You don't see your physical body at all in your dream. But you undergo a fantastic dream, going for a picnic with all your friends, having a very good, pleasurable time. Suddenly, the sun sets. And it has become the whole dark, and you are lost in that darkness. Each one is shouting, helter skelter. How suddenly such a vast cosmos and such a vast sun that is also setting in the dream, and during the daytime you were enjoying your picnic with all your friends and relatives, and suddenly things have started happening in a different way altogether. Either you suffer or you enjoy in dream. How those experiences are already fixed in the dream. In the same way, our whole this 24 hours, especially the waking state, cosmos with our individual being, playing different roles, encountering different roles, responding to the challenges of those roles, moment to moment, all those things are also already predetermined. These are all happening out of unconscious past registrations. Everything is a past registration. This moment is a past registration. I have been advising everyone to look gently within, gently, very softly. Altogether, the whole of this, your name is Stephen Francis, no? Look at whole, en masse, with all your character roles. That particular one individual who undergoes various roles, that Stephen Francis, you look at him, you be with him gently. This gaze should not jump down to concluding, deciding, I am able to watch, I am not able to watch. While I speak with other people, I am not able to keep my observer and look at them. See, underneath, the silence never goes away from you. Underneath all your physical or psychological thinking, there is stillness. stillness never goes away. It is never an arisen stillness. Equally, the silence is also never has arisen in you. It permeates. That is what is the limitless, unarisen, unmoving, silent, stillness and silence of our self, real self. We are by and by, very slowly, very gently, we are going into that frequency. We are not going towards thinking. We are not going to observe our thoughts. We are not going to observe our feelings, moment to moment. We are going to make an inner gaze permanently 24/7, whether you are awake during waking state and you are fully slept in your deep sleep state, or you are undergoing dream, irrespective of changing these three states, we are sitting in a special gaze very, very gently, because it always exists. We are not attuned to it. We are not informed about it. We are not advised about it. This is the self. There is only one self. It doesn't have a form. So, don't judge. While speaking with my friends, while transacting with my friends in the past 1 hour, I had completely lost myself. I did not see myself at all. I went through the discussion. Myself was lost in the discussion. I slipped away in the discussion, making judgments, corrections, modifications, advising others. In the process, my eye was lost from my own observation. There are no two eyes, that is capital letter I. There are no two capital eyes. One observer and indulgent. One is indulging in activities. The observer doesn't take an higher position. He is sailing along with the indulged. Whoever in you initiates a conversation, transacting with some other person, you are with him also. When your audience or your customer, whoever actually responds to you, you are in them also. You never cease to exist at any point in time, even in your waking state, transactional life. Such a type of very fine, very gentle, actually it is an observerless observer. It is an observerless observer. We are not trying to becoming more skillful. We are not taming our skills, intellectual skills in the process. We are not setting any goals at the end of this observation for that observer. He has no goal at all, because he is an unarisen observer. This fundamental fact, you have to bear it in mind. Be gentle. He just can't go away. Because he is your, this Francis, Stephen Francis, as a employee or a manager in your firm, whoever, whatever the kind of post you are carrying as your role in your office, this is only coming and going. Such a paradigm shift will take place in you if you take interest in you. You will have to take interest in you. What you need is complete interest in the real self. You are after reality. You are after that reality that exists during your deep sleep state. It is a stillness you are wanting to merge within. It is the silence in which you want to invest all this noise, deposit all this noise, talks, the inner chatter, whatever the transactions. You don't know what sort of a confidence you will get the moment you feel you can simultaneously do all the transactional life, talking with so many people. See, every day I have been taking satsangs. I never slip out of that at all. There are no two eyes. Initially, you will have to put in all efforts. The effort should be always on the real self, not on this. What now you are asking is, you provide me with such a self-inquiry that the self-inquiry also automatically goes when I do live my transactional life. Even in those moments, even when I speak, this observer should be there. There are no two observers at all. Even in thought, Even in thinking, there is only one thinker for one thought. Thinker itself is the thought. Thought itself is the thinker. Observer itself is the observation. Observation itself is the observer. There is no dichotomy at all. There are no two things at all anywhere in this cosmos. There is only one self. That is why the truth is very easy. If you really pierce through the thinker in you, you will immediately end up in self. That is what is self-realization. If you realize that the thinker in you doesn't have a reality, intrinsic reality at all, that is what is Jivan Mukti, that is what is liberation. What we have been advising is live a life of self-realization throughout 24 hours. You won't miss anything. You won't miss any part of your life. All the erstwhile fragmented way of living will fall into one as you will enjoy when you eat food, you will enjoy eating. When you talk to your wife, you will enjoy talking with her. In full completeness, you won't miss anything. You will feel the love of everything because this is pervaded by that only one love, the self. That is what we are actually training our inner gaze to dwell deeply within. So don't stand apart as if, don't keep a Stephen as a holistic observer and he is now entering the office. While entering, he has complete observation. By and by, he loses the observation. And Stephen is lost somewhere in the transactions with other friends and customers. Don't have that kind of dichotomy at all. At no point in time, there are two observers existing in one. There is only one. There is only one self. That is what they say. Don't. It is aridarku arivitarku anniyam indrai. Anniyame illappa. Separation இல்லை, அதரே இல்லை, ஒன்லி ஒன் தான் இருக்குது. ஒரு தாட்டில் கூட அதுதான் இருக்குது, ஆனால் அதுக்கு தெரியல, நம்மளுக்கு தெரியல. அதனால தான் முதல்ல வி ஆஸ்க் எவ்ரி ஒன் டு கெட் பிஹைண்ட் த தாட், கெட் பிஹைண்ட் த திங்கர். யுவர் ரியல் நேச்சர் இஸ் சைலன்ஸ், யுவர் ரியல் நேச்சர் இஸ் ஸ்டில்னஸ்.